Hi. Session 33 writing task is to write a letter to family GP, Dr. Lacrisel referring Mr. Pittman, who was admitted to nurse lead outpatient clinic in the Newtown Hospital with deep laceration on lower left arm as a result of an accidental injury with hand saw while cutting wood, requesting to do a full cardiac assessment and management of Mr. Pittman's hypertension. Here, you are a nurse in nurse lead outpatient clinic in the Newtown Hospital, where Mr. Pittman was admitted, and you're writing a referral letter to family GP asking him to do a full cardiac assessment and management of Mr. Pittman's hypertension. Let us look into the case note first. This is a simple and very straightforward case note. The name and age of the patient is important and should be mentioned in the reference part of the letter. Here, not all the information are relevant and need to be mentioned in the letter. Since a letter is written to the family GP, the patient is already known to the doctor, hence you can avoid mentioning the patient's family job, habits and past medical history. Moving further, we can see a lot of dates along with some information. Even though all the information provided are relevant, you should take special care in organizing the information in an impressive manner so that the continuity of the letter is not lost. Since there are a lot of numerical given, you can use them while framing the letter, but it would be much appreciated if you don't overuse them while framing the letter. The assessment and plan mentioned in the case note are relevant and should be emphasized in the letter. Taking all these points, we have to prepare a letter in an organized manner. Now, let us see how we can write a letter with the help of a sample letter written by a candidate from UK. The date written is correct, but the format is wrong. Here, you must write 14 July, 2018. The address written is correct. In the salutation, the candidate has missed a comma after the name. In the reference, you must write it in a single sentence, that is RE colon Mr. Waiter Pittman, 69 years. Moving to the introduction paragraph, I write to refer Mr. Pittman, who requires cardiac assessment and management at your service. Here, you have to keep in mind that when you're writing a letter to the patient's GP, you don't have to use the word refer. Here, the candidate has not mentioned the condition of the patient, which is a very vital information. We can rewrite this introduction in a much impressive manner, like, I am writing to request a full cardiac assessment and management for Mr. Pittman, who is suspected to have orthostatic hypertension. Moving to the second paragraph, Mr. Pittman was admitted to hospital with complaints of deep laceration on lower left arm. On admission, his wound was cleaned and sutured. Prophylactic antibiotics given for the patient. He was discharged from the hospital on 3/7/18. On the next day, he was admitted to the hospital with complaints of severe pain and mild hematoma. His pain was 8/10 on pain scale. Here, the words admitted and admission is repeating in the first two sentences. You can reorganize these sentences as, Mr. Pittman was admitted to the hospital with deep laceration on lower left arm. His wound was cleaned and sutured and he was managed with prophylactic antibiotics. The second last sentence says, on next day he was admitted, which is wrong because the case note says he complained about severe pain and mild hematoma while he was visiting the outpatient department for the wound management. Therefore, you can rewrite the sentence like, on his subsequent visit for his wound management, he complained about severe pain, which was 8 out of 10 and mild hematoma. Moving to the third paragraph, on observation, Mr. Pittman's blood pressure was 186/89 mmHg while sitting. His supine blood pressure was 190/86 mmHg. On the subsequent days, his blood pressure was still elevated, but his wound is healing well without infection. The patient is diagnosed as orthostatic hypertension. Here, the first two sentences should be clubbed together and placed at last of the previous paragraph. As on observation, Mr. Pittman's blood pressure was very elevated, 186/89 and 190/86 in sitting and supine position respectively. The third sentence can be restructured in such a way that, on subsequent visit, his blood pressure remained elevated, but his wound is healing without infection, which is much better. The last sentence written here is wrong because the patient is not diagnosed with orthostatic hypertension but is suspected to have orthostatic hypertension, and this information should have been placed in the introduction paragraph as already discussed. Moving to the fourth paragraph, pertaining the above information, kindly assess the patient and please provide proper management for his hypertension. Here, you can instead simply say, I humbly request your attention on this case, or please do the needful and contact me if you have any queries. Coming to the wind-up sentence, you have to mention the name of the patient along with the sentence. Then it becomes, do not hesitate to contact me for further queries regarding Mr. Pittman. In the sign-off, the candidate has missed a comma after yours sincerely. Considering all these factors, the letter will score for 180. Thank you.